إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series of tafsir. We're still working about Surah Luqman, the wise man, Surah number 31, which Luqman is giving advice to his son. Today, inshallah, we'll be working with verse number 18. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ السَّمِيعِ الْعَلِيمِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَلَا تُصَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور واقصد في مشيك واغضض من صوتك إن أنكر الأصوات لصوت الحمير ألم تروا أن الله سخر لكم ما في السماوات والأرض وأسبغ عليكم نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة ومن الناس من يجادل في الله بغير علم بغير علم ولا هدى ولا كتاب منير وإذا قيل لهم اتبعوا ما أنزل الله قالوا بل نتبع ما وجدنا عليه آباءنا أولو كان الشيطان يدعوهم إلى عذاب السعير. Last week we discussed part of the advice of the wise man Luqman to his son, and we mentioned about the important of the Amr bil Ma'ruf and Nahi anil Munkar, and that every Muslim, male or female, responsible of carrying this obligation according their means. People have a different capacity and capability over such obligation. And I give example, a person who is a parent have more ability and more rights over the family to admonish them and correct them physically, mentally, spiritually, by all means that he can or she can. Because the Prophet ﷺ had informed us that each one of us is a shepherd, is a governor, and each one of us, he going to be responsible about his government. Your government can be 2 people, can be 50 people, can be 5 million people, it depends. So a ruler or a king or a president, he has to carry this obligation more than a parent. And a parent have to carry it more than a neighbor. Why? Because it goes back how much authority you got. Nevertheless, a Muslim have to do it to the best of his or her ability, because the Prophet ﷺ told us that مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ. Whosoever among you see something objectionable to the deen of Islam, different from what Allah ordered and His Messenger ﷺ, let him change it, correct it, bring it to the right direction with his hand. But if he could not, let he or she talk against it. But even if you don't have the means to talk, or you could not talk, you can talk, but you will acquire more responsibility or hardship beyond what you can carry. So the minimum will be what? That you disapprove it in your heart. That you reject it in your heart. That inside you, you make Allah his witness that such a thing is wrong, is different from his deen, and that you disagree, disapprove, okay? Because the Prophet ﷺ says that there is nothing beyond this from Iman. That means if you see the munkar, and you did not even get irritated to see such a munkar, now you are 0 in Iman. We ask Allah to protect us from such a state. So Luqman continued talking to his son, saying, وَلَا تُصَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِي في الأرض مرحا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور. And لا means don't. تسعر turn away. And سعر is a illness or a disease that catches the camels in their heads or in their neck, which doesn't leave them until their neck will become twisted. So he used this expression telling you, don't do like this. Don't turn your neck away. Don't turn your face away from the people, looking down upon them. When people addressing you, give them a full attention. Humble yourself. Don't be arrogant. So don't turn your way. Don't turn your face away from them. Don't turn because you see that these people are nothing. Okay? ولا تصعر خدك. خدك means your cheek, which basically on the face. All right? So don't turn your face away from them as if they are nothing. You don't care about what they're saying. You don't want to listen. Okay? So we have to have a public discipline, how to deal with others, how to humble ourselves, regardless. Okay? You listen, and after this you can refute or disagree or correct, but don't act as if you are better than this person, and now you move your face, not paying them attention. ولا تصعر خدك للناس. Don't turn your face away from the people. And ولا, and do not. تمشي from مشي, to walk. في الأرض, on the earth. مرحا, with arrogancy, lot of pride and arrogancy. Inna Allah, verily, Allah, la yuhibbu, he doesn't love, from hub, love, doesn't like, doesn't love. كل every مختال arrogant فخور boaster. So we see that many verses in this surah had focused in the issue of arrogancy. And as we stated before, that arrogancy, it caused Iblis to get out of Jannah. So arrogancy comes from the shaitan. And a Muslim have to get rid of this problem, because it can take him out of Allah's mercy. When the Sahaba understood about this, they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because they thought that wearing a nice clothes or wearing a nice shoes, this is part of arrogancy. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught them what is the proper meaning of being arrogant.